I looked out the window. It was late. Rain trickled down as if it was trying to wash away the sins on this godforsaken city. This place was the Neverland for delinquents and lost souls. And in front of me was the worst of the lot. They looked tired and beaten. They've been through it. Like a stray dog on its last leg, alone and hungry. I knew I needed a confession. It was the only way I was going to make sure they'd get locked up for good. But how? I looked over, saw the way they looked at me. This was my ticket. A game of cat and mouse. The old good cop, bad cop. Listen. I'm sorry about earlier. But I'm sure you understand. Being a female cop in this city, you need to demand their respect. You don't seem like you're that bad of a person. I'll tell you what. Do you care if I make myself a little more comfortable? Great. Thanks. So, you look a little uncomfortable. Why don't we make a deal, you and I? You promise to cooperate with me. And I'll remove those nasty little handcuffs. Do we have a deal? Great. After all, I don't bite, and I don't think you would hurt me hard. Hold still. They're just a little tight. There we are. Are you more comfortable? Good. Though I do find the handcuffs more fun. Do you smoke? Allow me to get a light. It's hard. So, why don't we just take things nice and slow? Just to have a conversation like old friends. After all, I just have a couple questions. And you have the answers. So, why don't I just read you what I have and you? You fill in the gaps for me. Sound good? Great. Shouldn't take too long. So, I heard you were in the hospital a few days ago. What happened? I see. I have on record that it says that you were badly beaten. Is this true? Did you know of the assailant? You had no idea. So, do you have any enemies or anyone who would want to hurt you? Well, a good-looking person like yourself must have a ton of ex-lovers. Or jealous significant others. Well, regardless, this situation must have made you very angry. Well, I know if I were in your situation, I would want revenge. So tell me, where did you go after this hospital stay? How dare you lie to me? You're so naughty. I have here from a very reliable source that you were seen at a gun shop. Now tell me, why on earth would you need a gun? For defense? You sure you weren't trying to compensate for something? So tell me, did you find anything there that caught your eye? Anything that made you feel powerful? No. That's funny. Because I have a receipt right here that says you purchased a handgun. Tell me, what did you do with this handgun? As I didn't find it on you. A gift. I see. Okay. Tell me, does the name Nancy mean anything to you? Well, I can tell by your facial expressions that I must have hit a nerve. Me and my colleague saw you entering Nancy's earlier in the night. Tell me, what were you doing over there? Now, did you know that Nancy's lover had died? So did you choose to visit her before or after that happened? You're looking a little nervous. I mean, I know it's hot in here, but things are just only heating up. There's a speed limit in this town, and it's 45 miles per hour. And you are going 90. So why don't you tell me what happened at Nancy's? Did you know Nancy prior to going over there? I see. Well, I heard from a very reliable source that Nancy quite fancied you. I mean, who wouldn't? So, she wanted to get your attention. Sound right? But she didn't know how. But then, it clicked. A jealous lover. You, being the tough person you are, would come looking to get revenge, and she'd get to talk to you. However, she was hoping to dispose of him before she saw you. And you were in the wrong place at the wrong time. And you pulled the trigger. Admit it. You're not going anywhere. Except for behind bars for a very long time.